The concept of honoring black women made me want to be a part of this movie. Black women from the past, the present, and the black women who will shape the future. Women like Maxine Waters, women like my grandmother, women like my ancestors. And I think this was is an important film that will speak to how the past directly influences our present and our future. I think I also was attracted to the themes of the film. You know, systemic racism, microaggressions, white supremacy. And I think, especially with the time that we're in, it's important to shed even more light on these toxic issues. The burden that black women have to carry to deconstruct white supremacy and racism every single day doesn't get talked about enough. And I felt like this was an opportunity to shed light on what we're going through daily. When I was reading the script and thinking about Veronica and all the Veronicas that I know, because she reminds me of so many strong, black, educated pillars in the community. You know, Veronica is very community oriented. What she does is not just for herself, you know, is to uplift her community, to move black people forward, and to help us not assimilate, but to be, you know, revolutionaries of our own life. And I think that I was drawn to that. I was drawn to just how much of a modern day superhero she was and she is. And one of the other things that's super important is how she deals with, you know, an oppressed system, a system that does not work for her. And I think Veronica wanting to dismantle those systems that were not built for her with us in mind is something that we need and something that we need to see more of. Eric and Jack are you know, some of the best actors in the business, and I was super happy that I was gonna get an opportunity to work with them. I knew that for everybody, you know, these roles were gonna be heavy. And they were going to be asking a lot of ourselves, and we would have to go outside of who we are, you know, as individuals. When I met them, it was important for us to just talk. So we didn't film anything without having conversations around race, you know, around oppression, around white supremacy. It was important that we went out. You know, it was important to the directors as well that all of us had an opportunity to connect human and human to human to understand where we stood. And there was some really important and eye-opening conversations that stem from our talks. I was familiar with their film Against the Wall and the work that they had done with Jay-Z. So I knew, you know, that this film was super important for them to execute, and, you know, just seeing their passion for wanting to make sure that every detail was paid attention to, I really respected and appreciated that. One of the other things that was important to me is that I had black designers when I was Veronica, you know, and she worked hard to figure out how to get, you know, local black-owned designers to contribute earrings and skirts and dresses and jumpsuits. So that's what I love too, is that she went out of her way to make sure that we were highlighting, you know, black designers, because this is a film speaking about black life. The things that Antebellum deal with, the themes that this film deals with are white supremacy, microaggressions, systemic racism, and the burden that black women carry to deconstruct white supremacy and racism every day. I think that it's even more important that we talk about these things because of the times that we are in. We are in a fight right now. We're in a real fight. And the things in this film haven't been as global as they need to be. We're seeing people wake up for the first time and address the delusion of white supremacy. And what this film shows and what we see right now is that the past is not the past. The past is not even the past. And I think that will be made clear after you watch it. I think this film will make a lot of people uncomfortable. And I think that it should. I think that in order for us to grow and create something new, growth requires discomfort. And everyone is feeling it in different ways. So my hope is that after folks watch this film, that it prompts them to do something about it. I think that art has a way of ministering and of getting people to have that aha, I finally get it moment. You know, sometimes it doesn't work in a speech. Sometimes politicians, they don't articulate it or make it plain or say it in the most passionate way that you have to listen. And art does that. And that's why I love being an artist, and I try to stay true to that, even if I have to go through the pain like I'm going through in this film, to come out on the other side to showcase that on screen is just something that is remarkable and has the power to change hearts and minds everywhere. One of the other things that was so special about filming this movie is that I got to work with some of my favorite actors. And Kiersey Clemons is, to me, somebody that everybody should be talking more about. You know, her performance in here was just outstanding. And both of us had to really lean on each other, you know, between each take. Because we understood the weight, we understood the responsibility that we had to portraying our characters and our ancestors. And I just remember her, you know, looking at me and looking in those, me looking in those big, pretty eyes and finding my power. Finding my power. So I really love working with her.